Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I am Vivek Chen. Make sure you follow every instructions in this video and don't forget to like and share.
Today I will be demonstrating how to set up a Bastion host to securely access your AWS infrastructure. A Bastion host is a server whose purpose is to provide secure access to a private network from an external network, such as the internet. I like to keep my presentation short and to the point, so I will not be wasting time by clicking button on AWS console. In this demo, I have provided AWS CloudFormation template that set up all the environment shown in the screen. You can find the URL of my CloudFormation template in the description below. If you already know the Bastion concept, you can skip to the remainder of this video and just use the template. However, I would still encourage you to fast forward and go through the videos, because at the end I have given further ideas on locking down the access to Bastion. So let me go ahead and launch the CloudFormation template so that the AWS can work in the background while I return back to explain the concept.
I am not using a root account to perform this action. I am logged in as an admin user. Before we proceed, we need to set up few prerequisites. You need to have SSH key created and stored in your laptop. It is important to name your key properly. For example, you can name your key as login to Bastion, etc.
So let's come back to CloudFormation. We'll choose a key name, login to Bastion, and click next.
Also, reserve a public IP for Bastion. This step is optional, but if you don't use reserved public IP, each time the instance is restarted, its public IP changes, and cost of updating your mobile extra may be more than the cost of buying a public IP.
Coming back to the concepts, what is Bastion? Bastion hosts are instances that sit within your public subnet and are typically accessed using SSH. Once remote connectivity has been established with the Bastion host, then it acts as a jump server, allowing you to SSH to log in to other instances deeper within your network. When properly configured through the use of security groups, the Bastion essentially acts as a bridge to your private instances via internet. One of the six pillars of AWS Well-Architect framework is the security. You need to prevent intruders from getting access to your servers. So run your cloud servers in a private subnet which is accessible to log in only from the Bastion and not from the internet. And then you tighten the access to the Bastion host. Now you might ask me, what is so special about Bastion? Isn't it just another server? In that case, can the intruder hack into it and then easily access other private servers? So firstly, we need to minimize attack surface. On a Bastion host, reduce your attack surface by hardening operating system, minimizing components, libraries, and external consumable services in use. For example, running SSHD service is sufficient. On another hand, the other servers are hidden behind Bastion, so it reduces exposed attack surfaces. Next, we can further secure the Bastion host configuration using Linux and OS hardening and applying Linux security baselines. Next, we need to allow access to Bastion only from the whitelisted IPs. Lastly, we need to enable multi-factor authentication to access the Bastion servers.
Now let me show you the security groups. How you name the security group matters a lot. Choose proper naming convention for security groups so that access is not granted inadvertently to wrong hosts. You can see this security group is open to all IP. If someone gets hold of SSH key, they will be able to log in. That means there is a single point of failure. Even if they don't have my SSH private key, there are vulnerabilities or bugs in SSH daemon which would expose the bastion host. We can further secure it by allowing only my IP address to log in. Let me Google my IP. What is my IP? We will collect the IP address, then update the security group where this security group allows traffic from all the IP address. We need to change it from all the IP address to my home ISP IP. Now I will show you how to set up Mobile Xtreme to log into this Bastion server.
To log into the host, first we need to collect the IP address of the host. Let's collect the public IP address and let's move to Mobile Xtreme. Here in Mobile Xtreme, let's start a new SSH connection. We will specify the IP address of the host we just took. Let's specify the username and let's direct the path to the private key we just stored in our local system. When we try to log in, it verifies the public key to our private key and then we are logged into the system. In my next tutorial, I will show you how to allow SSH login from the Bastion host to an internal server and also set up a one-click access from Mobile Xtreme to your internal server. I also have another video talking about the setting up two-factor authentication to log into the Bastion host.
I hope it was informative. Do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon.